My name is Doug Bradley. People are going to know me most, of course, from playing Pinhead in the Hellraiser movies. I originated the part in the first movie, which we shot back in 1986. I played in 7 subsequent movies, so 8 altogether. And many other things, TV and movies. Most recently, last year, I was in an episode of Law, which is on Amazon Prime currently. It's an Amazon original production, which we shot in Prague. Last year, I am in the Burke and Hare episode playing Dr. Robert Knox, who was the Edinburgh surgeon who kind of commissioned Burke and Hare's activities. So that's the most recent thing that I've done. Well, The Wicked and the Damned is a compilation of 3 first-person narrative stories with an intertwining wraparound narrative. So the basic setup is that there are 3 characters who find themselves on a planet called Silence, which is a mortuary planet. And the 3 characters don't know each other. They're not sure how they got there or why they got there. And they agree to each tell each other what they remember immediately prior to finding themselves on Silence. And so they proceed to tell those first-person narratives, which is a narrative of their narrow escape from death, which is the last thing they remember before finding themselves on Silence. And there's a monster story, a ghost story, and a story that is kind of a psychological horror story, and then it all wraps itself up at the end and pulls all the strands together. It's cleverly constructed, I think. For The Wicked and the Damned, I think the first point of reference for people would be the First World War, because it's that sense of trench warfare that seems to be going on for its own sake and not getting anywhere. My own character, the narrator of the story, Commissar Valdemar, is a man bound by a sense of duty and an unflinching sense of responsibility in executing that duty, mixed with a level of fundamentalist religious certainty of his place, and that he is guided by the God Emperor. I always feel approaching doing an audiobook recording, half the battle is done for me if I enjoy reading the story in the first place, which in this case I absolutely did. I didn't have any expectations of it, but I think Josh Reynolds has done a great job with the writing, and I enjoyed reading it myself, which helps make the reading of it easier. And it's a pretty powerful story, and I'm sure people will enjoy it. I hope so. Well, I was aware of Warhammer, and for that, really, I have to thank my son. When he was in, I would say, his very early teenage years, or maybe just turning 10, 11, 12, thereabouts, I think, in the early 1990s in London, he discovered Warhammer and got into it in a big way. And every evening after dinner and homework, he'd settle himself at the kitchen table and paint his Warhammer figures, and I I accompanied him on many journeys to the Games Workshop, where he'd gaze in awe at all the figures and try to work out how many of them he could afford, and watch the people playing the game. And he got himself a gaming board and bought himself the trees and all the rest of the stuff and built his landscape and found friends that he could play the game with, and persuaded some of his friends, who I think weren't really all that interested, that they really wanted to play Warhammer with him. And I thought it was all pretty cool. I remember I particularly liked, I think there was a skeleton army. I had, I don't know whether I still got it, I had, I think it was a skeleton hearse, drawn by skeleton horses, I think, from that collection, which I kind of kept for myself. And indeed, he and I made a trip to Warhammer headquarters in Nottingham, in England. And we got shown round everything there at Warhammer HQ. And I think, I mean, I still see Games Workshop shops around in places. So I was aware that it was still going on, but to be perfectly honest, I didn't realise that it is still as huge and popular as quite clearly it is. Audiobook recording is its own discipline. It's an aspect of acting, certainly, I believe. The art of storytelling. The principal difference, obviously, is that you're on your own. And that if it's true that that 99% of acting is reacting, then you're left with the 1%, because it's all down to you. So it's a discipline, and it's its own excitement. A lot of actors, I think, don't really enjoy doing it. I always do. I think I learned to read when I was very young, and I know that from as soon as I could read, I liked to read aloud, and I always have done. I continue to do it, much to the consternation of those I share my life with. So in a way, I've always been doing it, and the enjoyment is storytelling, of creating atmospheres, of telling the narrative, unspooling the story, and creating characters as you go along. So although you can certainly wind up sick of the sound of your own voice and wishing somebody else would come in and do the work for a while, it's just you and the microphone and the headphones in a darkened little space, and it's you can lose yourself in the world of the story very completely, I think, and hopefully bring the audience in with you. Well, this seems to me to be a whole new departure for Warhammer. I believe so. I mean, as I say, I was familiar with Warhammer back in the day. I'm less sure about exactly what the developments are with it now, and when the offer came to me to do this, this was the first time that I knew anything about the Warhammer Horror imprint. I think it's a very, very exciting direction for Warhammer to move in, to start producing these short stories. I was very impressed. I think the quality of the writing in The Wicked and the Damned, and the story I'm reading myself, The Beast in the Trenches, is outstanding. And obviously it gives a whole other element and dimension to the Warhammer world for people who are already fans of Warhammer, and maybe it will be a way of introducing new people into the Warhammer world, or that people will just find a new strand of horror audiobooks to enjoy. The more the merrier. I certainly hope that there will be lots more of these stories in the future. As to what type of horror story, I don't know really. Far be it from me to try and tell the people who know the Warhammer world what they should be doing with it. The great thing about horror is that it is very elastic, it's very expandable. It always reinvents itself, and just when it, people always like to write horror off and say that it's run its course and that it doesn't have anything more to say. And of course, that is never true, and somebody will always find some new twist on an old tale or something new and original that hasn't been said before. As long as there are writers with imagination, there will always be new horror stories, and those will fit themselves into the Warhammer world quite well, I think.